Welcome to Thoughts and Things in Focus. I'm your host, Patricia Chu, welcoming you to another edition of Thoughts and Things in Focus. Thoughts and Things is a community program for youth and community, and how can community help our youths? We are very pleased to present to you the Guyana 52nd Independence Celebration that was held at Brooklyn Borough Hall, hosted by the Brooklyn Borough President, Mr. Eric Adams, and presented by the Guyana Council Late and the Council General of Guyana, Honorable Barbara Attali, and the Guyana Mission Ambassador, Mr. Rudolph Tempau. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the celebration of Guyana 52nd Independence Celebration. Also, we are inviting you to our community health fair, which should be held at the Brooklyn, which should be held in Brooklyn at Bethel Deliverance Church, 397 Rockaway Avenue. We welcome one, we welcome all. Our vendors will be Guyanese Nurses Association, the Brookdale Hospital, Kings County Hospital, Bank State Hospital, Emergency Planning, the Fire Police, Education, Affinity, Health Plus, and many more organizations will be there displaying and giving the information of health education. Our health department will be there too with the information. So come on down, come on one, come on all, and have fun with Thoughts and Things community. If we bring all the children, there will be lots of giveaway and lots of goodies, information for everyone, the old, the elderly, the young, the old, and the babes. So come on down and have fun with our community welfare on July 14, 2018. See you there.
Can you see by the clouds? Ambassador, extraordinary and penitent. government officials, ambassadors, fellow consuls general, members of the diplomatic corps, distinguished advisors, members of the media, ladies and gentlemen, fellow guides. Very good evening to you. Good evening.
Good evening.
Along on behalf of the permanent mission of Guyana to the United Nations and the Council General Cooperative Republic of Guyana, to extend very warm welcome to each and every one of you here this evening. It is indeed a pleasure to have your participation as we commemorate our 52nd anniversary as an independent nation. This year's celebration, we are doing this under the theme, Six Peoples Living and Working Together in Unity. On May 26, 1966, after more than 350 years of Dutch and British rule, our country became an independent nation. It was the culmination of centuries of resistance by generations of our ancestors. Independence for us was a triumph of will and perseverance of our people. Today, 52 years later, we pay homage to their contributions that laid the foundation for a unique and new nation. From their struggles of slavery, indentureship, and colonization, our people have displayed intolerance for systems of domination and injustice. Today, we enjoy freedom because of their consciousness and courage. This inherent nature of defiance must be demonstrated in the face of any threat to deny us of our freedom and sovereignty. Independence vested in us the duty to protect our nation and to pursue the best interests of all generations. However, overcoming challenges as a nation can only be done as a united force. Even now, as we face the threat to the integrity of our borders. As we reflect on our nation, all 83,000 square miles, our natural resources, the people, the tremendous strides to development, and the progress we have made over the past 52 years, I urge you to recommit ourselves to those principles of independence and pledge to work selflessly with our people as we continue towards a future built on the ideal of six peoples working and living together in unity. Once again, welcome all to this our 52nd anniversary celebration. Fellow Guyanese, happy independence.
Ladies and gentlemen, after listening to the presentation, you welcome from our Council General, your emotions are going in different directions to your respective villages that you came from. And we are warriors video, music begins. To express the emotions that you're looking to express, please help me welcome you to the microphone, how you may present the musical rendition, named for your thoughts, Native Land.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, now you know why the instrument of the pied piper was a flute, because I would walk behind her from Brooklyn to Bartico. Three greetings. And to introduce our keynote speaker, let me invite to the microphone His Excellency Ambassador Rudolf Tedbach. Mr. Tedbach.
Honorable Vice President and Minister of Foreign Affairs of Laos, Excellencies of the Diplomatic Corps, Honorable Consul General of Laos in New York, distinguished guests, friends of Laos, fellow Laotians, the task that I have been assigned this evening is to bring you greetings, and a more pleasant task I could not have asked for. We are gathered here one day before the 52nd anniversary of our independence to celebrate how far we've come in these 52 years, but also to reflect on where we are now and the road that lies ahead of us. Yes, there have been setbacks along the way. Independence is a learning process. Even this great country in which we are celebrating today took nearly 100 years after its independence to take the first steps towards healing its internal divisions by officially abolishing the institution of slavery. And it took another 100 years after that before meaningful progress was made towards bringing all Americans together and embracing their diversity. But let me say, as we reflect on where we in Guyana have come from and where we're going, that I am bullish on Guyana. Bullish because now more than at any other time since independence, we have within our grasp the opportunity to achieve the good life for our generation and for the generations of Guyanese to come. We've always had the resources. We've always had the people. Smart, creative, resilient people. But now we're beginning to see something new emerging. A new confidence in ourselves and what we're capable of achieving. We are confident that, given the opportunity and the tools, and with the right mental attitude, a team of Guyanese teenagers can master the difficult science of robotics in 1 year and lead a field of 164 countries in an international robotics competition. We're beginning to see more and more the golden arrowhead waving proudly atop the winner's podium in international sporting competitions. And we're beginning to see a new attitude in our people and in our leaders. An attitude that sees difficulties as temporary and as opportunities if we are creative and positive about them. Our forests in Guyana, that we used to refer to as the bush, we now see as a treasure trove of valuable timber and ecotourism potential, a storehouse of biodiversity, and a carbon sink to help the world slow global warming. The rainy season flooding in the coastline that we complain so much about is not a curse or an act of God, but a reminder that that we are blessed with abundant rainfall and bountiful fresh water. All we need to do is to manage it better. There are parts of the world where people can only dream of having such abundant rainfall and fresh water. We used to complain about the hot midday sun. Now we are thinking about renewable solar energy. And lastly, and most importantly, we are beginning to see the diversity of our peoples as a strength and not a weakness. To recognize the importance of putting together and building coalitions. Recognize that we are stronger as one people and one nation, despite the historical circumstances that brought our ancestors to the shores of Guyana. But I'm also bullish about Guyana because we are fortunate to have national leaders who have a vision for the future of Guyana and who are going about the task of making that vision into a reality with professional competence and with absolute commitment and dedication. One such leader is our second Vice President and Minister of Foreign Affairs, the Honorable Carl Barrington Greenwich. Minister Greenwich has made the trip to New York especially so he could be there with us this afternoon. And I know how logistically difficult that was to do. This is testament to the importance he attaches to Guyanese in the diaspora, who have a key role to play in our national development. Minister Greenwich needs no introduction. His high profile, both in and out of Guyana, is a reflection of his wide experience at the national and international level, a reflection of his intellectual effort and of the choice that he has made to place his experience and his intellect at the service of Guyana. He too was once a member of the diaspora, but he chose to return to serve Guyana. And so I now have the honor and the distinct pleasure to call upon our second